tonight. And the truth is the same. I'll be great tomorrow within this brief space of elegance. Days, who mafias take us far away.
Episode of the Jay Stone Show. The Jay Stone Show. It's fucking November 6th. Holy shit. It's November 6th, 2016. And we're dead in Tarpon Springs, Florida at rockmetaltalk.com. So doing that stupid voice there, you know, that's just some shtick. But I made a post today about a fellow, Ned, who has a radio show, and they interviewed one of the nameless ghouls from Ghost, which I happened to meet this week here, which was a very cool experience. Great live show. But I don't know. That's one of the reasons I despise testicle or tertesticle radio, is because of the fake voices. This is my real voice. Sometimes I overdrama. But those days of radio, I agree, are over. Some people just have a natural radio voice. You don't have to overdo it as an announcement. Everything doesn't have to be an announcement. Like Kingmaker, the brand new Pretty Maids, is coming up right now on WNBC. That doesn't, you know, we don't need that shit. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about. So I had to lock my cat in the back room that's right behind the studio here in my house because my fucking sprayed bleach because my dog don't feel well and the dog's going into the fucking back room. So now I got a cat fucking howling. But I don't like that radio announcement shit. It's funny. I do it as a goof, but, you know, whatever. The guy's a tool. It just makes the interview seem so fucking phony. So I'm not sure if Rob is calling in from Devious Management. We've been talking, but I haven't had time, man, to text him, and I apologize. But last week I was sick, so I had to force the show and just play music for my segment. I still have something going on, but, you know, I'm working so many fucking jobs, so many hours. I'm doing the radio. I'm doing the fucking chip runs. I had to bring the truck to get the air conditioner fixed. I had a million things on my list to do. I've been running around like crazy. I have barely slept in fucking 2 weeks. I had one day off. I don't know, maybe 2 days off since September sometime. So shit's pretty crazy. So if he calls in, he calls in. But we have Justin. He's the former drummer of Martyrs Asylum. He's in a new band called The Fine Line. So him and a couple of the guys are probably going to Skype in later in the show. I just have to give, you know, the opportunity to wait to see if Rob's going to call in, because somewhere along the line, I just didn't have time to get in touch with him this week, man. I just really didn't. So it is what it is. But we only have 5 shows left for the rest of the year. Let me look at the schedule here, because after December, we got the 13th, the 20th, the 27th, and the 4th, and the 11th of December, and then 18th, 25th, and the 1st. The show is going to be on break. I'll put together something somewhere along the lines. I'll put like a best of together with the Cats and Yama when Martyrs Asylum played live on the show, Yoshi, Gish. We'll do something like that. And maybe we'll have some more material for you. But a lot of stuff is going on. I didn't formally get to welcome Johnny O to the show. He's got a segment. He does the Pick 10. So last week he did some horror stuff. This week him and his guests talk about Metallica and their top 10. So it's pretty cool. They sound great on the air. Everybody's doing a great job. Ricky, Katsunyama, Alicia, everybody's doing a great job bringing their segments in. Don't have to harass anybody, man. They just do it. They just do it. And that's what it's all about, is just getting it fucking done. None of us make money from this. We promote ourselves. I'm a Z-rated fucking celebrity in the neighborhood. So, you know, my dog's more famous than me in the neighborhood. Everybody wants to fucking talk to him. But that's not why I do it. I do it to get bands out there. Like my brother John introduced me to a band called Pretty Maids back in the day, and they had a CD called Future World, and it incorporated keyboards. So it's one of, you know, I always liked the keyboard elements, and when I was younger I got goofed on a lot for that. But you know, I heard a band, Nocturnus, they incorporate keyboards into death metal, and that's some great stuff. Actually, Mike Browning, he unfriended me on Facebook. It's pretty funny, because I guess I'm too fucking hardcore, but whatever. They're a great band, and they incorporate it. I just love the elements of it. Pretty Maids, Future World was a great album, and you know, they've put albums out over the years and they've all been pretty good material. But this Kingmaker, I listen to every track. There's not a bad track on it. It's coming out. I don't have the release date. Schmitty sent it over to me because he's a guy I work with. That's how I get a lot of the material for my show besides buying it, is I've been working with that guy since the beginning of the show. I mean, I've been doing this show since probably I developed it in sometime in 2007 and just had to work out how I was going to do everything. And I think I launched the first show somewhere in 2008. I don't even know, man. I can't even remember. But we're thousands and thousands of shows. I did the Bank and Stone show. Don't Censor Me with Jay Stone, Spoiling the Dead. I was on some ESPN station, Sirius XM. I mean, thousands of shows in, man. I did more specials and interviews. It just all blends together. It's like, it's the nature of the beast, man. If I take a nap on the day of the show or whatever, my brain just knows to get up. It's time to fucking go roll into the studio and do a show. But it is what it is, and there's a lot of people who reference this show. You know, it's not just heard. My stats, I'm not going to claim I have the greatest stats at rockmetaltalk.com. I used to, but, you know, I was one of few and far between as far as a rock metal talk show. So I had a good audience because I was one of the only ones doing this type of thing. There was maybe several of us, like Hair Metal Mansion and stuff like that. But And Dominic from Maximum Threshold has been doing it a long time, too. So it was easier. Now, you know, everybody's a podcaster. Everybody's fucking, you know, got an opinion. Everybody's fucking asshole stinks. You know, it's all the same, blah, 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 blah. And I appreciate Katz and Yama telling me that the show wasn't the same without me last week. I still wanted to put the show on for you guys. I appreciate that. That's totally, you know, a great compliment, but, you know, I'm not all of that. You know, I'm just the host of a little fucking show that gets aired, you know, on multiple outlets in other countries. It's just something I do. And, you know, if I can't do the show one week, I apologize. I very rarely cancel anything. As of late, I've, you know, had a few issues with, you know, health and flu and different shit that I can't just fucking shake. Work is a fucking stress load. So I can't, you know, I don't always have it in me. And, you know, it pains me not to do the show. And even sitting here listening to it, I wanted to, you know, chime in last week, but I couldn't. I just couldn't do it, man. I had no fucking voice left. About a half hour before the show, I got sick. I threw up. I tore my fucking throat up pretty bad, man. I had a lot of fucking shit caught in my chest. I don't want to get too graphic because I don't want to make you puke. Not that, you know, it's going to make me puke because I can't smell it from here. But, I mean, you can obviously tell. I mean, my voice is different from week to week, and it's just because that's what it sounds like. Right now, I got to cough my fucking brains out, but I'm holding it back because of the show. So what you heard in the beginning there was Sanctuary, I Am Low. It's fucking Warl Dane, fucking Nevermore. Love those guys. It's a great band. My watch is telling me to breathe. It's always during the show. It's always the same time. Like, I fucking stopped breathing. But I did that segment already, so I won't do it again. But really, like, I wasn't breathing the whole day. If I take a deep breath right now, I'll fucking hack up my other lung. I just can't shake it. There's a lot of weird news. I want to talk about The Walking Dead and why I'm not doing the Spoiling Dead that I'm just going to talk about it on this show. So it's fucking insane. Glenn's dead. I'm not really spoiling anything, but whatever the case may be, it was a great fucking episode. The fucking